The next one will come in up through the upper Midwest. And, you know, like all clippers, it'll be a fast mover. This one actually might be a Manitoba mauler, though, because I think it's coming out of Manitoba. But either way, it's going to be a quick mover. Now, temperatures out ahead of it today, we're going to see going from the teens up to the 20s. You know, temperatures appropriately chilly, not crazy cold, just, you know, it's winter. So we'll see the chill in the air. Looking ahead to your forecast for today, any snow out there will be very light. We get into tomorrow, and here comes that next clipper, or Manitoba mauler, as sometimes they're called when they come out of Manitoba. We're going to be watching that bring in some snow showers again across lower Michigan. We'll see again a light coating of snow sweep into the northeast getting into the weekend. This one should not have as much accumulation. We see on Saturday another stripe of snow coming in. The places that get more snow is when you get a little help from the lake. So we'll see that downwind of Lake Erie and Ontario south of Buffalo, where we could get another 5 to 8 inches of snow getting in through the weekend and through Saturday. Again, behind the front with the clipper. So here's Green Bay. We do have snow in the forecast. We got 7.1 inches of snow yesterday. That was a record, broke the old record of 4.7. And there is a little bit of snow with this next clipper coming in Friday night into Saturday. But again, the snowfall should be light, not another 7 inches kind of snow. All right, Seth, let's go south. And this time it's not going to be snowy. And we actually do have some delays to talk about this morning. So let's bring in the airplane. There are delays at LaGuardia. There is a ground delay program. I think it's Delta only flights, if I read the notes correctly here, of what's happening because of de-icing delay concerns. And so there are actually 8 airports that are de-icing this morning. A bunch in the northeast, Salt Lake City, are actually de-icing as well. That can cause minor departure delays. Sometimes that can add up into more, right? So you keep an eye on that. We do have the light snow coming into the northeast right now, but it's in and out very quickly. So hopefully these are any short-lived delays elsewhere. Great weather for travel today. All right, let's talk about the next snow system. It happened so quickly too, and you just think about saving your pet. You don't necessarily think about the ice. We want to keep you safe and your pet safe as well. Look, you guys are ready for the winter, right? Your winter jackets are out. The ice scrapers are ready to go. Your furnace is inspected, but we need to make sure that your pets are ready for the season. Our furry friends need to do things as well to get ready for the season. And we've got tips for you to help keep you and your pet safe. So if your pet likes riding in the car, and I know a lot do, make sure to never leave them alone in the car, even if you think you're going to be right back. You know, inside temperatures inside your car can drop very quickly, especially as air temperatures outside are dropping well below the freezing mark. So let's talk about the ice as well. Unless you are absolutely sure that the ice is thick enough, don't allow your pet to run outside and get on the ice. Just like us, pets can fall through the ice. They can get hypothermia just like we do, and you don't want a wet pet in the winter for any reason. So if your pet does get wet, make sure you wrap them in a nice warm, dry blanket. All right, what about your cats? So, you know, cats, they like to wander, right? You want to restrict their access to the outdoors in the winter because they can become disoriented if the ground is blanketed with snow, get lost, and then freeze. And this next one is very important. So you want to make sure you keep any antifreeze, rock salt, or any other chemicals away from your pets. You don't want that to get on their paws, and most importantly, you don't want them licking dangerous substances that can do them harm. It's also a good idea to let their fur grow thicker and longer in the winter. Make sure you have any appropriate jackets or coats or little booties to keep their jackets warm. And you want to cover their paws with booties and occasionally check for any bleeding or cracked areas. Now, lastly, this one is good all year round. Make sure your pet has an ID tag. It's a little easier to get lost in the winter when there's snow on the ground. And a lot of time, you know, when your dog sees the snow, it just takes off running. It gets so excited, just like we do, right? So make sure you follow these tips to keep your pet safe during the winter so you all can enjoy the majesty of the season. Yes, that is the question. It is now 11 days until Christmas. Get your shopping done. And let's look at the forecast, because that's the other big thing that you plan on. Will you have a white Christmas? It's, you know, look at the odds. So this is the chance of having a white Christmas. And by the way, snow doesn't have to be falling to make it a white Christmas. You have to have snow, 1 inch of snow on the ground or more, or snow falling to be officially a white Christmas. Syracuse, you in general have about a 58% chance when you just look back at history. But Steph, there's a good chance that Syracuse will have a white Christmas.